Hello dear students, now this is paper 2nd for class 11th and the name of the paper is the semiconductor devices, in which the second chapter deals with the study of transistors. The transistor is a solid state device and it is made up of silicon or germanium. The transistor's name, it is derived from that it offers the transfer of resistance. So from the word trans and resistor, it is combinedly known as transistor. There are two main types of transistor, as they are called as bipolar junction transistor and unipolar junction transistor or field effect transistor. The transistor can be used as an amplifier or as a switch. So let us move forward to learn about the transistor. The first topic here in the study of transistor is the types of transistor. A bipolar junction transistor is a silicon or germanium type crystal which has three regions present in it. The name of the regions are emitter, base and collector. These transistors are formed by combining two p-n junction diodes, and one junction is in between the emitter and base and other junction is in between base and collector. The types of BJTs so formed are called as NPN transistor or PNP transistor. In the diagram you can see there is a junction between emitter to base, and the emitter is N-type, base is P-type, and again a PN junction diode is joined there. So combinedly P-type will combine to form a single region, single base, which is of P-type, and N-type will be the collector. So here how this NPN transistor is formed. In the similar way, we can join PNNP diodes to form PNP transistor. The symbols are like this. You can see NPN transistor, N-type emitter. So emitter's arrow is indicating, and it is directing from base to emitter. So base will be P-type and emitter will be N-type. In the similar way, PNP transistor can be also symbolized, and you can see that emitter to base, the arrowhead is from pointing from emitter to base. So that is why emitter will be P-type and base will be N-type. So this is how you can remember the symbols of PNP and NPN transistor. The function of emitter is to emit the electrons in NPN transistor, and it will emit the holes in PNP transistor. NPN transistor emitter is of N-type, so it has free charges as electrons, and these electrons are emitted by the emitter. In PNP transistor, the emitter will be of P-type and it will emit the holes. As the emitter is a source of charges, it is heavily doped and the base is lightly doped, and the doping of collector region is in between the emitter and base. The area of collector region is maximum, since it has to require dissipate more heat, because all the current from the emitter through base, it is collected by the collector. So the physical area is maximum for collector. The area of emitter region is smaller than that of the collector, because it has to emit the charges, because it is not collecting that. So area is very less. The area of base region is in between the collector and the emitter. As this region is minimum to prevent recombinations of holes and electron in the base. Now this transistor has to be connected in the circuit, and the connection in electronic circuit of any device is called as biasing. The transistor can be biased into three ways. First way, if both the junctions are forward biased. Both the junction means junction between emitter to base and junction between base to collector. So these are the two junctions. If these two junctions are forward biased, in this method the emitter and collector currents are very large and the transistor will operate in the saturation state. Second type, if both the junctions are reverse biased, in this method the current is negligible. The transistor will be in cutoff state and negligible reverse current will be obtained because of the minority charge carriers. The third type, if emitter based junction is forward biased and the base to collector junction if it is reverse bias. In this method, the transistor will act as an active device because it can be used to amplify the input signal and it produces the larger output signal. So that is why the transistor is in the active state. The last is, if emitter base junction is reverse bias and the collector base junction is forward bias, this is actually meaningless, because if this transistor has to be used as an amplifier, there will be an input and input will be connected to the emitter base, and if emitter base junction is reverse bias, there will be no current in the output side. So that is why this combination it is not taken. So there will be only three types of biasing types are there, and when this type of biasing circuits are used, the transistor will either operate in the saturation region, cutoff region, or in the active region. So these are the biasing methods or my biasing types of transistor. Now let us see about the operation of transistors. First of all, we will consider the operation of the NPN transistor. You can see in the diagram, we have shown a figure of NPN transistor. Here you can see there is a depletion layer present between base 2 emitter and base 2 collector. In the transistor, there are two junctions which are formed between emitter to base and base 2 collector. For biasing of the transistor, mostly the active region or active state it is used. So that is why where the input is connected, that input should be connected between emitter and the base, and this region must be forward bias. The output is always taken between the base and collector, and this base and collector region must be reverse bias. Then only the transistor will operate in the active state. So in the diagram you can see the negative terminal of the battery VEE, it is connected to the n-type emitter, and the positive is connected to the p-type base where holes are there. Then towards the right hand side, the output side, that is the collector to base region, collector is connected to positive terminal and the collector is of n type. So this is how negative biasing or reverse biasing is achieved at the output. Now under such type of biasing, the stream of electrons from the negative terminal of the battery, it will start flowing towards the n type region. The majority charge carriers in the n-type emitters are electrons. Therefore, there are already free electrons which are present in the emitter, and we are increasing this number of electrons or quantity of electrons by applying the negative potential to the emitter. So therefore, many electrons crosses the junction J1 and enter into the base. At the same time, few holes from the base will goes to the emitter, because when the electron moves to some place, there will be creation of hole. So that is why holes from the base, we can say that they are also moving from right to left, that is from base to the emitter. So the net current in the emitter will be due to the both charges. So that current can be considered as the current due to the electrons plus the current due to the holes also. As the current in the base due to holes is very less, as it is considered as a minority charge carriers, so that is why hole current is very negligible. So all the current in the emitter can be considered as the current due to the electrons only. So when the electrons from the emitter diffuse through the base, few electrons recombine with the holes in the base. Since the base is lightly doped, this number is very less, and we can say that if we consider the emitter current is of 100% of electrons, so near about 2% of electrons they will diffuse in the base. Now remaining about 98% of electrons reaches the depletion layer. These holes are swept out of the base into collector by reverse bias voltage, and the collector current, it is also comprised of two currents, the currents due to the electrons and the color current which is due to the thermally generated charges. So this current due to electrons from the emitter and the current which is in the reverse direction, is it is the reverse leakage current due to the thermally generated charge carriers in the collector. The collector current is nearly equal to the emitter current, because the current supplied from the emitter It is passing through the base and reaching at the collector. And nearly all the emitter current is reaching at the collector. So that is why we can say that the collector current and emitter currents are equal. The transistor equation can be derived as the emitter current is equal to the base current plus the collector current. In this current, as the base current is very small, so emitter current and the collector current are near about same. This is how NPN transistor will works. Now second thing, let us see the example of PNP transistor, how it works. In the same way, we have to draw a crystal semiconductor diagram. You can see in the diagram, there is a transistor and this transistor is of PNP type. So P-type emitter, P-type collector and base is of negative type. There is a junction between base and emitter, which is denoted by letter J1. And there is a junction between base and collector denoted by J2. This J1 is forward bias. As you can see that the battery voltage VEE, its positive terminal, it is connected to P-type emitter, where the battery VCC, its negative terminal, is connected to the P-type collector. So this is how the input side, that is the emitter to base, it is forward bias, and the output side, that is base to collector junction, it is reverse bias. Since PNP transistor is a complement of NPN transistor, the operation of PNP transistor can be considered here to explain the operation of PNP transistor. Here also the net current in the emitter will be comprised of both the charges, that is the electrons as well as the holes. But here, as the emitter is of P-type, so the holes are majority charge carrier, while the electrons are minority charge carrier, and the current in due to the minority charge carrier is very less, so all the current in the emitter will be considered as due to the holes only. The current equation in the collector can also be explained like this. The collector current is also comprised of two components, the collector current due to the holes and the reverse leakage current in the collector, thermally generated electrons, that is negative charge carriers. So here transistor equation, it will be same as the emitter current is equal to the base current plus the collector current. Here also the emitter current, we can classify that all the 100% of emitter current, only 2% of current will diffuse in the base and remaining 98% of emitter current will flows towards the collector. So the collector current and the emitter current will be same because base is very lightly doped. So emitter current and the collector current here also the same. So this is how the NPN transistor will work, and in the same way PNP transistor will also operate.